Y'all, like, I feel like that was probably the most comedic set I've ever been a part of. Like, I knew every day I'd get the set, and there would be I we would just buckle in laughter at something. Usually Liza being Liza and doing Liza things, but yeah, like that was my favorite thing. That was my favorite part of the process was that A, I got to work with a friend of mine that I'd known for years that we had never gotten to actually work on anything together. Like, that's really, really special. And you being an EP on it, I was just so proud. And I had a couple of other buddies that were part of the project, and so being able to be a part of it, like, in that way, at that capacity, and to create something that we all knew felt pretty special was awesome, you know?
I slept like a baby throughout the duration of filming
Oh,
because
yeah.
everything, like, it was like a release of laughter and just like being so tired from whatever they were throwing at us on set that day. Because it, like, what was really interesting about our movie is, like, I remember the table read and all of us feeling like, what's missing?
Yeah.
And it essentially ended up being the dancing, really brought our movie, shocker, but it really brought our movie to life in know was there for until all of us got to know each other, come together and feel like a family. And like, I know a lot of sets will come off saying like that and saying that they create, you can't help it. Like, when you're all
Right.
thrown together, and especially like you've said this so many times, like, dancers have such a different energy and radiate such a different love and joy, that I think that was really special for all of us to be together. And one more thing I want to ask you, because I've heard you like say this a few times and you always just like, I don't know, put together so
Sabrina,
perfectly.
you're doing so well. I'm sorry. I'm so impressed with you right now. Keep going, please. Okay, that was it. Keep going.
Just gonna thank you. What do you want people to take away from this movie? Because you've stated this before.
Yeah, no, it's my favorite thing to talk about. I mean, I think that there's the Jordan that grew up watching the dance films, everything from Save the Last Dance to Honey to the Step Up series, my favorites, You Got Served, blah, blah, blah. There are things that are typical and there are things that are atypical in dance films that I think really kind of sheds light on why they're all so special and why they work all the time. More, yeah. That was weird. That was working. Yeah. Okay. Cool. I just want to make sure because he felt like diversity is awesome, right? Especially being a person of color and growing up in an industry where oftentimes a lot of the roles that I didn't book was because I either wasn't white enough or wasn't black enough. Dance films have everything, have everyone, all shapes, sizes, colors, creeds, orientations, religious backgrounds, sexual orientation, like all of the thing. And getting that key art initially, it brought tears to my eyes. I was like, I can't, this is so, it's always needed, but it's really needed right now. Inclusivity is just the name of the game. And that's kind of how we all need to live our lives and lead with is love and inclusivity and so on and so forth. But the thing that I really hope that people take away from it's a couple of things. I could dilute it down to, like, I hope that people feel good. I really want people to feel good in the way that we feel good, felt good making it, and the way that as fans of the film, not only were we a part of it and we're part of the creation of it, but I feel good after watching it. I hope people take that away from it. I think that the main thing that I love about it and why I'm so amped about Work It and why I love to talk about it in general, especially with it being a dance film and in that genre, dance is definitely the category. Like it's that vehicle that takes you from point A to point Z, but